I want to show you here a work that in one time integrating the four dimensions. If you look, one dimension is a line of only a length. And here I use the simplest form possible, the circle. But if you multiply one dimension, you arrive to two dimensions, a surface. Multiplying another dimension, you arrive to three dimensions. Time is something that doesn't repeat, and usually in most work consideration of time doesn't exist. In all my work, the dimension of time, the fourth dimension, is the most important dimension. This is a three-dimensional object, so it would stand like this still forever, like any three-dimensional object. I could see it like this, my sons, my grandson, forever. But let us see here now, it will become a four-dimension, instead of time. Then it's moved. And when it's moved, you don't know where every piece is. Because here the laws of harmony is different. Here the perfect disorder equals harmony. Like in life, you see people in the street, you see sunrise, sunset, the clouds. There's a kind of perfect disorder that creates the harmony of nature. So every touch here would create another movement. And the expression is movement, like a beating heart, like something is alive. The number of permutations are infinite. If I touch it like this, for example, let us see something like this, then you get another shape. How would we consider it? How would we look at it? How would we remember it? How would we describe it to ourselves? Would we think this walk is like it is now? Like it was here, or like it was here? Like it was, or like it is? Or probably like it will be, because it's at the time element. Using the dimension of time, you can create infinite number of possibilities.